Peepla the Purple Butterfly here, otherwise known as Peepla7 on Twitter and YouTube, Peepla elsewhere on the internet. My blog is located at purplebutterfly-peepla.blogspot.com, and my soaps, Purple Butterfly Soaps, can be located at peepla.etsy.com. And after 3 years of faithful service, my e-leaf eye stick died. Threads were all stripped. I couldn't get it to hold without, like, taping or sticking something in there, and you know, so I bought another one for $49. I bought a 50 watt mod that is temperature controlled and everything, that makes my little $80 20 watt e-leaf eye stick look like a wimp. But it only came in three colors: silver, bronze, goldish looking, and black. Really? Come on, some of us girls like pink, purple, blue. So I did this. Ta-da! And this is an AVO 50 watt. And as you can tell, it has a vents and, you know, a pass through. I'm gonna put some tape there, and some tape there, and some tape here. So that way when I fine tune this design, I don't have to worry about, oh, I got something gooped up in there, because, you know, just let it dry. This is acrylic paint, and then peel it off, and then put some nail polish or something on top of it. But isn't that gorgeous? And no one else has anything like this. So no one can say, hey, I used to have one just like that. No, you did not. You don't lie. This is color I put on there. I like when things are unique, which is why I took the Rit, this is Teal, and this is Fuchsia. Make sure when you do, you shake this stuff up really, 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 really good, because otherwise it'll do that grab the color thing and not disperse onto your project. And make sure you use, and shake this up too, shake this up more. Make sure you use this to fix that color on there. So that way when you have projects like the one I was telling you about, and when it's completely done, even if you wash it, and this is a purse, which means it won't get washed, might get dry cleaned or whatever, but it, the color will be like that. Okie dokie. And this is how it looked when it was finished. And she loved it. She started crying on me. Wasn't expecting that. Anyway, ta-da! This is the site you've seen me working with. I make sure I cut that tag off. And this is the back. It's still a little damp right here, and I explained that you might want to let it, you know, sit down and air dry, or put it in a dryer over low heat, or in fact, it would be better if she used air dry cycle, or just let it sit until it can, you know. But those paper rolls that I put in there, it was all the way through here, they were soaked, because by the time you do the whole thing, I took the paper out, laid it on the thing, put it down, put some paper towels on, rolled it completely up to get rid of all the water. Then I blow dried the inside, and I blow dried as much of the outside as I could, but you're still going to have those little teeny corners where the leather met the cloth that has to air dry. So that's how I did that. And let's go over a few things while I still have some time on this tape. The water. Make sure you use really, really hot water in a separate container than the fix, because if you go like this, spray one side, do the work, and then put the fix in, spray that side, do the work, rinse that out, shake out all the, you know, old, and put in some new water, it's going to congeal. The fix does not just wash away. So make sure you have a separate container for each part. I took the Tilex that I usually use for doing anything that's going to die, because it has bleach in it, and it clears up anything that's bleach. Well, we ran out of that. So I took some regular bleach and put it in a container for a bleach cleanser, so that way you don't have to, I mean, it even says bleach cleanser. This is a generic, no name, but still, But that way I don't have to label anything or go, what is this? Oh, no, it's already labeled bleach cleaner. So it doesn't matter which bleach cleaner I put in there. You know, we don't want to mix chemicals. So if you have to do that, rinse one out, put the new one in, but it's already labeled. So anything that has touched the spray, the ceiling, the bottom of the sink, the tub, or whatever, anything that you had to dye in, spritz that down with the bleach cleanser, let it sit for 20 minutes. So then when you go to clean up everything, no trace, no sign that there was a big pink spot over there, and a big green spot over there, and a big purple spot over there. Yeah, get rid of the evidence. Toby think I just cleaned the bathroom. She didn't know I was working on this project, and it came out gorgeous. So make sure you have a separate water bottle for those. Make sure you have a labeled water bottle for that. These are 4-inch bows that comes in a 10-pack that you can get at Michael's, Hobby Lobby, Walmart, anywhere. These things are amazing. They hold your project. If the dye, like right here, some of the teal stayed in there, and I've washed it twice. This, toss it. I didn't mean to actually toss that, but anyway, the sponges, I mean, I write what I'm doing or what I'm using on mine, but when it's at the end of the day, or it's too far gone, or I didn't get the fix on there instead of the dye, toss it. 10-pack of those, so no big group. And then, say for you only use two, these things make excellent makeup brushes, so go for it. And then, when you will usually toss out makeup brushes or have to try to wash them or whatever, because bacteria will pile up or build up, instead of sterilizing, toss it. So, that's all I have to say about that. Give it a try. Make sure you use a bleach bottle separately labeled that says bleach. Make sure you have a hot water plane for your, you know, to disperse the dye. Make sure you have a separate bottle. Put in a different color for the fix. And then have fun making something look like this. Bye now. This has been People at 7 on Twitter and YouTube. People at elsewhere on the internet. My blog is located at purplebutterfly-people.blogspot.com. Y'all stay blessed. Stay happy. Bye now.